Today at home, we are making this McDonald's style McPizza puff recipe, which is a crispy and flaky puff with a pizza filling inside, which is saucy and cheesy. This is just the way, but much more better. You will totally enjoy this at home, guys. Let's get cooking. Welcome to CookingShooking. So for making the pizza McPuff, first we will make the filling. For that, here I have a pan. I'm heating it up on high flame. As the pan is getting hot, we will also add the oil, about 2 tablespoons of that. Once the oil is hot, take about 4 or 5 cloves of garlic and then add it. Along with the garlic, I'm also adding some more of the ginger garlic paste. You can use either one of them as per your choice. But the pizza McPuff has a lot of garlic flavor. That is the reason I'm using the extra garlic. So cook this for about 20 seconds or so. After that, we will add the onions into it. Here I'm taking one onion, which is medium size, chopped fine. Cook it for about 1 minute. We just want to ensure the raw flavor is gone. After that, we will add the capsicum into it. Along with the capsicum, I'm also taking the carrot, peas, and the corn. All of these ingredients are chopped into the corn size. Basically bite-sized pieces, guys. If it is very big, then it won't cook. Now you have to cook this for about 2 minutes or so. If you add the salt right now, it will be very easy to cook them. So I'm adding the salt. After that, I will continuously stir this and roast it for about 2 minutes. So basically our roasted vegetables are done and they are par cooked right now, basically half cooked right now. We will add the sauce into it. In the sauce, today I'm using the Viva pizza and pasta sauce. You can use any pizza and pasta sauce and you should be fine. But I've heard most of the hotels use this one. That is the reason I'm using this. Along with this, I'm taking about 2 tablespoons of tomato ketchup. I used basically 3 tablespoons of the pizza sauce, 2 tablespoons of the tomato ketchup, and about 1 tablespoon of red chili sauce. So basically pizza flavor, spicy flavor, sweet flavor, along with that a little bit of white pepper powder, and we will also add the oregano mix. If you like it extra spicy, then you must add some chili flakes. So here I'm taking about 1 teaspoon of chili flakes. Now it's time to cook them for about 1 more minute. You will see how the vegetables will come together and it will form into a lump. We don't want that to happen, we want it to be saucy and nice. So for that, what we will do is we will add about 1/2 cup of water and just ensure this is saucy and not dry. You can add the water as per your choice, but at the end, it shouldn't be very saucy also, otherwise the filling will come out of the puff. So in total, I have taken about 3/4 cup of water and I have brought it to a boil. This looks good, the vegetables are half cooked, they have a bite right now. Done for now, I'm going to turn off the flame, wait for it to cool down. In that time, we will take a kneading plate for making the pizza puff dough. Here I have about 1 cup of flour or maida. Along with that, we will take a little bit of salt and then mix it together. After adding the salt and mixing it, I'm making a well in the center. And here we will take about 1.5 tablespoons of oil. You can also take 2 tablespoons of oil and then mix it together. If you add more oil, then it will be flaky. If you add less oil, then it will be crispy. So the choice is yours. This is the benefit we get of making at home. So mix the oil really well. You will see how this will bind together. The oil is well binded. Now we will add water into it and then we will make a dough out of it. This will be very crumbly, guys, very dry. So add water little at a time. If you add too much, then your puff will not be crispy. So be careful with the water amount. At the end, we need a stiff dough out of this. It shouldn't be very soft. You can see the texture right now. It is very well hydrated, but it is very stiff as well. If required, you can add some more water, but we have to knead it for about 2 or 3 minutes. Otherwise, it will be dry. So after kneading it also, you can see it looks good, not very smooth, but it's perfect for right now. We will cover it and let it rest for about 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, our vegetable filling will also cool down and the dough will also get soft. So basically the gluten in the dough will relax and that will be perfect. You can see our filling has also cooled down and it looks good. The texture is great. Now we will add the grated cheese into it. Not much, we will just take about 1/4 cup of the cheese and then add it in. Here I am taking Amul pizza cheese, you can use any cheese that you like. See, I added about 1/4 cup of cheese, still it looks very good. So this is also done, now it's time to make the puff. For that, all you have to do is check the dough, it should be relaxed like this. So it looks good. Now we will divide it into 4 portions. You heard that right? You don't have to make small portions right now. Just divide it into about 4 or 5 portions and then we will begin making the puff. The problem with making puff at home is if your dough is small, then you will face issues in shaping them. So it's best to keep it big. You can cut it and reuse it. So I'm smoothening out the dough portions. After that, we will take one of it and then we will try to roll it. For rolling it, you can use a chopping board or a chakla as per your preference and use a rolling pin and then begin shaping. For making the pizza McPuff, we will require 2 sheets basically, so it will be best if you shape it into a rectangle shape. You can see I've gotten an oblong rectangle kind of a shape, it looks good. Now we will try to shape it even better, in the sense, try to use a knife and cut the corners. After that, you should get something like this. Again, don't worry about the size, we will fix that later on. Right now, just divide it into 2 portions. So there I've got both the 2 sheets that we require for making one pizza puff. Now it's time to add the filling and shape it. But be careful about the thickness of the pizza puff sheet guys. If it is too thick, then your puff won't puff. If it is too thin, then there are high chances that it will break while frying. So too many things to be careful about, but the taste at end will be perfect guys. So right now I'm taking about 2 tablespoons of the filling. We will place that in the center area of one sheet. After that, try to spread it around. Then dip your finger in some water and then try to apply water in the edges. This is to ensure our puff sticks really well. After applying the water in the second sheet also, you can lift it up and then stick it together. See how I am sealing it? After sealing the edges with my fingers, I am going to use a fork and then I am going to crimp the edges. With this, we will get a good design and the assurance of this being sealed, which is the most dreadful part guys. You have to ensure this is well sealed, otherwise it will open up while frying. So this one is done. You can make it shorter if you want to as per your preference. But right now, what I will do is take the second part of the dough and then try to shape it again. The process is simple, but just that it takes some time to make them. At the end, you will get something like this. You can see I have made about 6 of them. They are looking great. Now, we are going to cook them. To cook them, you can bake them in an oven at about 200 degrees Celsius. But if you want the same McDonald's like taste, then you have to fry them. So for frying it, here I have the oil hot in medium flame. I'm going to place them inside and then you will fry them until they are light golden. You will notice one thing right now, if the sheet is thick, it won't puff up, and if the sheet is thin, it will puff up. So here you can see one of them is puffing up and the second one is not. Once they are golden, you can take them out and then you can serve them hot. You can place the third one also, just ensure you are cooking them fast because there will be people waiting for it because the end result is so nice. So I am placing the third one also and we are going to fry them until they are golden. Once they are golden, you can take them out and you can continue adding the next batch and keep frying them. Here you can see our homemade pizza puff is ready and it is looking absolutely delicious. You can serve them hot or even cold as per your preference. So guys, that was my recipe for the McPizza puff and this is just the way as I said earlier, and I'm not showing the breaking part in the video. Keeping that for you, try this recipe out, click a photo and post it on Instagram and do tag CookingShooking, I mean cooking.shooking, and I hope to see that picture, like that picture, comment there. See you there guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you soon with one more delicious recipe. Until next time, make sure to click the like button and subscribe to CookingShooking for more such yummy recipes. And if you disliked it for any reason, no worries guys, click the dislike button. Bye, take care, happy cooking.